Hey everybody, hi, welcome. Thanks so much for stopping by and hanging out with me a bit today. Today is a very special day because I am officially kicking off my closet purge and extreme closet makeover. This is gonna be fun. I'm Laura. I'm so happy you're here. I do have sleepy sidekicks you may see that like to hang out with me. Wyatt is white puppy dog, Xena is the tan, and once in a while there's a kitty. That's Harvey. We sure hope you stick around for the long haul. Hit that subscribe so I can keep on creating content for you just like this. So before I open this door, let's set a little context. I moved into this house about 8 years ago, and everything was organized, had a place. I kept it up, it looked nice. I did a closet haul for you guys not that long ago. Everything was pretty much in good order. I took another role. A lot more responsibility, more travel. Things started to get a little chaotic. I was doing a lot of dumping my suitcase, refilling my suitcase. I didn't have time to organize and it started to get messy. And then a year ago, I took on another role, more responsibility, more travel, more time. And now it has reached epic proportions of, I will call, disaster. I can't find anything. I'm not organized. There is stuff everywhere. It is incredibly messy. Please don't judge me. I also had some, you know, family deaths, as you may know, and also a friend passed away. So things have just been getting into a place where the closet was not my top priority. So I came back from a work trip a couple weeks ago. Dragged my suitcase up the steps, opened my closet door, and I realized something was wrong. And this is something I had feared for quite a bit now, my husband had warned me about. But one of my racks had completely pulled out of the wall, screws and everything, and was now collapsed onto a bunch of other stuff. And that's when I said, okay, I can't live like this anymore. We're gonna do something about it. So come on into my closet. Once upon a time, everything was organized. I had all my long sleeves at the top rack, short sleeves at the bottom rack. I had jackets right here. I had sweaters in the back, dresses, and then I had longer hang stuff here, skirts, jean jackets, denim. That's basically how I had it laid out. But we're gonna just change it all and start over because I obviously lost major control of this situation. So what happens next? I take you on this journey with me because this is going to really be something amazing. And hopefully in the end is going to be a room that brings me joy. So the first thing I did was call for help because that's what you do when you're in a situation you're not sure how to dig yourself out of. You call for help, and that's what I did. So I started looking for closet companies that could come in and really help me do something here. So I met with a few. I chose one, so you're going to hear about that coming shortly. We've already scheduled the installation date. It's going to be amazing. In the meantime, I have about a month where I need to get everything out of this closet, get my husband to rip all of the wire racks down, do some patching, do some painting, get everything all in a perfect place for them to come in and create my dream closet. So I will take you on this journey with me. I can't wait till the end and hear what you guys think. So let's go on this journey together. So when I had to tackle my closet, I really honestly didn't know where to start. So I just started picking up all the dresses that had fallen and started sorting through all of them. I spent days making sure that I had sorted through every single item in my closet. As I took everything out, my intent was to get rid of about 40% because it had really been like 8 years, as I had mentioned, since I had really had a great closet clean out. And then the resale shop I used to use had closed in 2020. So for 4 years, I hadn't even done anything. My amazing friend came over. She helped me pull things out of my closet, get organized, and really go through and see what I had and what I needed to keep versus what I really could donate. And you'll see here that my amazing closet designer, Joy, came over. She remeasured everything. She really made sure that we had the perfect
information to make sure that my closet was exactly as we had planned. And the closet quickly emptied out. I shouldn't say quickly, it took me several weeks, but it really did empty quite well. I had, like I said, had a desire to get rid of about 40% of my clothes. I think in the end, I probably got rid of about 50% potentially. I didn't just clean my closet in this room. I cleaned up closets. I had cleaned up all the clothes that I had everywhere. We really got to it. Then my husband had to come in and he had to patch and paint.
Okay guys, so I'm coming to you from my nearly empty closet. My husband has almost all of the racks off the walls now. There's one small section up here in the front that he's still working on, but he's already starting to patch and cover everything up. He still has to paint over all the spots he's patched. Yeah, and we're doing cleanup as we go because it's the plaster has caused a lot of plaster dust, but we've been collecting that as we go. So I do have a shop back in here with me. And we are in a really great place because installation day is in less than 2 weeks now. So it's in two Fridays. Today is Tuesday. So he's got about a week and a half to get my closet completely ready for the install. So let's talk a little bit about what's been happening. So while I've been cleaning out all of my clothes out of this room, I partnered with California Closets, which I am super excited about. I did meet with other closet companies, but what California Closet brought to the table was so impressive as far as their creativity, their ideas for me to use every bit of storage that I have in here, as well as how they designed it, I just loved. So I worked with my amazing designer, and her name is Joy, and she truly has been helping to bring me joy. And we have went through several iterations of what I would like my closet to look like. For my lifestyle, this isn't a glamour room by any chance, although I hope someday maybe I can film in here. But this is meant to be really functional and really try to get me off on the right foot at the start of the day, right? So where I can easily find things. Everything is organized. I even have some cute little add-ons that are gonna make life, I think, just a little bit easier. But for the most part, I stuck to a traditional-ish type of closet, and I can't wait to show it to you, but we're gonna wait till the reveal, obviously. But Joy walked me through all of the materials I could choose, how they differentiate in the marketplace, which they do, I can tell you from just the different products that I have seen, the hardware that I would like to select, what grains, or if I wanted to go with a wood color. So lots and lots and lots of options. Then she went away and she tried to measure in here, but I'll tell you that at that time, I had so many things in here that it was hard for her to get a really good measurement. So she came back out and she sat down with me and we went over everything together again, making sure I understood all of what I have chosen from the product to be made with. So the wood, the colors, the hardware, everything that I selected. And we came back up here and we remeasured everything. So at that point, I still had clothes hanging in here, but not as much. It was much easier to navigate. She remeasured everything. We need to account for vents that are in here as well as outlets. All those things have to go into your design. And she walked through that all with me, remeasured everything and made sure that on installation day, it goes so smoothly. And this will be installed in one day. One day. I'm so excited. I cannot wait. All right, California Closets does offer a huge variety of different types of colors and wood grains and options. Your designer will work with you to really utilize the space in the best possible way. And this works for any type of space. So you think of California Closets for closets, but they do mudrooms, they do offices, they do garages. So any type of space where you need to redesign it so that it is organized, easy to use, and functional, they will do an amazing job for you. So the next part is to finish up all of this and then to get ready for installation day. Hey everybody, it is installation day. And as you can see, the entire closet is now empty. No marks on the wall. My husband took care of everything and the team that's gonna install just pulled up. All right, it's starting. Do you not love this? I love it, but I designed it, so I'm going to love it so much. I can't wait for my next steps, which now is to purge more of my clothes. I had a goal to purge about 40% since I really hadn't done a great clean out for several years. I think I did a solid 30 already. So as we come back in, my goal is to get rid of another 10%. So I'll be looking at everything. So it's gonna take me a while to fill everything back up. And then we need to style it a little bit, right? Gotta make it mine. So I can't wait until we get to the total final end, but this is what it looks like fully empty. I absolutely am loving these little ballet hooks so I can like put my outfit for the day, the next day, or when I'm planning to travel. This would be great for putting clothes and outfits on for planning. I love that. I had asked for the glass doors that were a little opaque. I love these, so they have a little bit of that blurred look to them, and that's what I had asked for. But you can order these any way that you like. You can get this in any design that you like, so many ways. The team was so professional when they came. As I mentioned, there was three gentlemen, and they were so efficient, asking questions about like placement of where I wanted my knobs here, just to make sure it was exactly where I wanted, if I wanted to put them closer. I don't mind this gap, but it would have been, you know, you could have brought them closer to make it look like a full circle. But I was good with them just like that. And they cleaned everything. So when they left, I am ready to move my stuff in. All of the shelves I can adjust here as well. Let me turn this a little bit for you. So you can notice all of these shelves, I can adjust to wherever I want it to be. So I can make these higher or lower, take them out. I don't have to use them, so I can give myself bigger space. But I do like having the shelves because then you're not overweighing anything, right? Everything has a nice spot for it. So much fun. I love, love, love my little bench here in the back. I added this because I wasn't sure if I'm going to have room for anything in the middle, but I'm going to try. But if I don't, I still have this. I might have my husband maybe put a cushion on it. So that's part of the styling I'll be thinking about. Or I may just leave it because it's adorable. But how cute is this? I love the black top and the black top here. You can also do any color combo. In my mind, my closet was always white. I don't know why. I just had it in my head. It was white, clean. That's what I wanted, but I did add the black accent just to add a little bit of spice to the overall look, as well as the blinginess of my hardware. Another great call out I wanted to share with you is that you can get inserts in your drawers for whatever you would like them to be. In this one, I did a jewelry insert. How fun is this? So all the little velvet placeholders, this slides over top of this bottom one. So many fun variations that you could choose. I'm in love with what myself and my amazing designer, Joy, created. This is going to be amazing. All right, this is the day.
I'm so excited.
I can't wait to show it to you. So hey, everybody, this is my amazing closet designer, Joy, who has been bringing me joy throughout this entire process. And when I met with her, that's how I explained it. I wanted a closet that would bring me joy, that would be functional, but yet be pretty, because my closet is not for show, it's for use. But I wanted it to be incredibly functional to use all the space that I have available.
Yeah, that was a real challenge, but we made it work.
It was, and we had several conversations about it. So I did talk them through a little bit about the process, about the different types of wood grains I could have picked, about the design process. But why don't you tell them a little bit about some of the challenges or the differences maybe with my closet?
Well, I think just sheer inventory, volume, you had a lot of things. And so we had to make sure that everything was going to have a home. The other challenge in your space, it's long and narrow. And it had the little pitches on the side, the little angled ceiling.
Right.
And so typically we would take advantage of the ceiling height, and we couldn't necessarily do that in this case. But I think we still made it work.
We did. We absolutely did make it work. Yay. And the volume has been decreased by 50%, I'm pretty sure, at this
point.
So it's going to make a huge difference, because I really did take, like, advantage of this opportunity for a complete closet redo.
And the purge is always part of the process.
It really is. And it needed to be done, and this was the best excuse to get it done.
Right.
So we're going to walk in, but I'm going to go first so I can catch Joy's reaction to this magnificent change.
So excited. Can't wait to see it. Wow, what a difference. This looks great.
Isn't it like a complete change?
Wow. This is a complete transformation. I am floored. I mean, there's always that moment where you hope your design is going to check all the boxes, mm-hmm. because it's great in theory, but you always wonder how it's going to be in practice. This is phenomenal.
It's such a huge change.
I love the chaise.
Yes. So I'll show you guys what that I did. Add a little bit of personalization. So as I mentioned, while this is not meant to be a show closet, it is meant to be functional. And sometimes I do just want to sit down and think about what do I need to pack? What do I need to wear today? Lay stuff out. I a lot of times will lay things out to see how they looked. And I picked a chaise because I thought that would be perfect. This one is not expensive. I found it at Wayfair.
Perfect.
I think it fits into the room perfectly. And I'll show you guys when we turn this around and then we can talk through it.
And even the lighting.
Yes. I
got to share the lighting.
I got all new lights. So I loved your reaction.
I mean, how could you not?
I absolutely love your reaction. Yes. So this has been a labor of love with your partnership. So thank you.
Thank you.
As I mentioned, this isn't a sponsored video. So Joy and I basically sat down and went through drawings. Like she drew this whole closet up for me. And I had worked with other closet companies as well. But in her designs, Joy brought some extras to me that I really felt made the closet. It really differentiated California closets from the others. And it was working with you that helped bring this all to life. But some ads that we'll talk about in just a minute really, I think, made it so that I could get to a place where I feel like all the clothes that I need can fit in this closet and I don't need them anywhere
Absolutely.
Else. So it worked out perfectly.
Well, thank you. Yeah. I think it's those moments. Your closet has to function. And anything we install is going to be beautiful and functional. But yes, it's those little extras that give you that boutique-y moment if you want it.
Yep.
And you really did.
I did.
And it did help to transform the space.
It really did. Yeah. I wanted to be functional, but I wanted those nice little pops. When I come in here, it felt like a nice room to hang out and not just grab my clothes and leave. And I think those are the things that made the difference. So we started with, and this was a great point that Joy had made. I'm not sure how much you guys can see. I'm going to turn just a little bit or maybe. Yeah. So on this, each side is shelving. So on this side, I have, denim and pants and colored pants. And on the opposite side, I have sweaters and t-shirts and tanks. That's how we started the space. And Joy had a really, great idea when she said, we want to make sure we put all of the shelves in the front of your closet because it widens it up.
Right.
Which is a great point.
The shelving is more narrow than your clothing. So by pushing all of the clothing to the back of the closet, it does make the space feel a lot bigger.
Yeah. So that was perfect. And luckily everything fit and I still have room. And then let's talk a little bit about these beautiful drawers and the doors I had to have.
Well, and you were very upfront about that. You said, this is important to me. And, it was a little challenging because you do have a lot of things. And I thought it takes up some real estate. But we just, again, had these moments. And we made it very symmetrical. So they're right directly across from each other. So we have the drawers and you picked out this beautiful hardware that just injects your style a little bit.
A little bit.
And of course, all the drawers and doors are soft close, which is nice. And you have the frosted glass, which means you still get the benefit of the storage, but it doesn't quite feel so heavy in here because there is a lot of stuff to look at. So that's a moment where you can kind of just get a break.
Exactly.
And it calms things and it just helps to break it all up.
Great way to say it.
Thank you.
And I went with the frosted glass because I wasn't sure what I was going to put on the shelves.
Right.
So a lot of the more closets that are a little fancier will have all the bags and the pretty things showing. I wasn't sure what all I was going to need the space for. As she said, I really had to purge quite a bit, make sure I kept what I needed, but I use every ounce of the space. So
correct.
I didn't want it to be like totally visible if I just had stacks of clothes there. It really doesn't need to be see-through.
Right.
But in this one, I was able to put all of my purses, so it fit perfectly. I have jewelry, so I already showed them. I had a nice little jewelry inset here, which was amazing. And then we get down to all of my bras, bralettes, all of those fancy things. And then on this side, we have room for those belts you can't hang up because some of them just have a snap. Right. And some little pocketbooks that I may carry, scarves, that kind of thing. And that's what I filled up in the rest of these drawers. So it worked out perfectly. And I was telling Joy, I actually have space. So I did not use up all of the space in this closet, which one would never believe.
Unbelievable. Yes.
You would find that to be unbelievable, but it's true. And I showed her. So I still have all the shelves in this on this side to
you
use.
You can go shopping.
I have space. It will probably happen, but it should not be encouraged. After this great
it's our
purge.
Secret.
After this great purge, it should not be encouraged. So it worked out just, I have to say, perfectly. And
thanks.
Then this was the lounge that the Chase that Joy mentioned in the very beginning. Super excited about this. As I mentioned, I found it on Wayfair. It wasn't expensive. And I went for something narrow because I didn't want to use up the space. I wanted to be able to stand here, look through clothes, have it not be in the way, lay things out, look at them. And it has the additional wonderful extra storage in here for the really big things.
So smart.
The bags, like those really big, like tote bags, weekenders, the blankets, like you, the wrap style things,
sure.
Those are all I kept in here and it fit perfectly. So it worked out just great. And Joy had said she wanted to come back out for us to finish the video when we actually had, I had it styled.
Yes.
So I did add a little bit of extra touches with the pop of turquoise and the pillows and this.
Yeah, that's the key to personalizing your space. Again, what we did was beautiful and functional, but adding your touches is what really makes the space your own.
Yes, thank you. So then we went with, on the double hangs, I did all of my tops and bottoms with long sleeve on the top, short sleeve on the bottom, jackets. Everyone knows who follows me that I love jackets. We live in PA, you need jackets. It's a thing that tops an outfit, right? I'm always cold, so jackets are my thing, as you will see. I was even able to have a section for like just the denim style shirts and jackets,
perfect.
Anything toppers that are denim. My space over here, this is also a bench. So I can sit back here too if I'm contemplating what I want to wear or what I'm going to pack. These I was able to put activewear in, so that worked out really,
perfect.
Really well.
Yep.
And then the more heavier items for when it gets colder outside, go here. And then we start with all of the long hangs, so pantsuits and dresses and
perfect.
the really long type of sweater, cardigans, that type of thing. And yeah, and then I did in this top part pants, and then we did sets. So things that were sets or random, like I threw my bathrobe in the very front here so I could get to it easily.
Sure.
So some of the extra things that we also talked about,
right.
And I needed to have, and I was so adamant about, was number one, and I'll zoom in here, but was a valet.
Right.
So this is really a fun feature. So this I loved because you push it in, it's out of your way. But when you are figuring out what you want to wear for tomorrow, this is the perfect hanger. When you're trying to figure out what to hang, this is the perfect piece. And I absolutely love it. And I was just talking to Joy that I think I might need a couple more just to put in the back
right.
of the closet. Because when you're packing, you want to be able to hang things up in different outfits. But I love it. It fits a lot. When I was bringing clothes in, I was sorting through this. I probably had about 20 items hanging from here as I was sorting through everything.
Perfect.
And it was perfect. I have one on the opposite side as well. Another amazing feature is...
the belt rack.
This is awesome.
But
we decided to put three of these in. Luckily,
right.
None of them are full, but I do have belts on every one of them, as you will see. And there is one more right here. And I kind of broke them out by the basics to those that are a little bit more fancy.
I mean, that's perfect.
It worked out perfect.
It really does.
Yeah.
And when you don't need them, they tuck away
and
you
don't
really see anything.
Yes, and it's all nice and clean. But so easily accessible, which I can tell you, one of the things I always struggled with, which were many in this closet, but was when I'm trying to get pack, and a lot of times I don't have a ton of time, I'm trying to hurry up and pack, And I would want that extra accessory, a belt, and I cannot find the belt that I want.
Right. And in our world, we've learned if you don't see it, you won't wear it.
Exactly.
So now everything is visible.
Exactly. Yeah. It's amazing. It's amazing. And then I will bring up the last thing that we talked about was that I have different from everybody else, I have a door here. So there is a door here that goes out into an attic. And previously, I just had crap here. I mean,
stuff
to be honest,
stacked in front of the door.
I just had stuff stacked in front of the door and it was piling on. It actually had marked up the door. My husband had to repaint it just from marks from me just putting stuff leaning against it. And Joy had an amazing idea for this space.
Well, actually, I mean, I'd like to take credit for it, but honestly, it was part of our production staff. She said when we were going over the pre-production review of your project, Joy, we can use that space. We'll just put a rod at the top. That way she can use it for hanging and it does not interfere with the swing of the door, which was brilliant.
It was. Yep. So this is perfect. I can take this rack off. I can just take the clothes off, set them here, take the rack off, and your amazing installation team showed me how to easily pop it right off.
Super
open
easy.
My door, do what I need to do, and then just throw everything back up here. And it's not so wide that it's a huge hassle to be able to do that when I need to. I hadn't been in it for about 7 years, so you can tell I don't use it a lot.
And we all know storage is important, so right. To be able to get access to that, key.
Easy, yep, yep. So.
I'm glad that worked out for you.
It did. The whole thing did.
I'm so pleased.
I'm very, very, very happy. This was an amazing experience.
And I'm happy you're happy. That's why we do what we do.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Laura.
So that's a wrap on my closet redo, and it was a complete redo. It took about 2 months. I have to say that it was a lot of work, but it was a much needed work. A huge thank you to my husband who really helped me get everything ready for this install. A huge thank you to California Closets for their amazing design. And of course, my designer, Joy, who has just been a rock throughout this whole thing and helping me make sure that I got to the right place that would work for me. I hope you had fun. Please hit that like, hit that subscribe so I can keep on doing this, and I will catch you in the next video. Bye, everybody.